Hello everyone, this is actually a program to test your ability in using while loops, the while loops inside while loops and the if statements, break and continue statements inside the loops. So before going to view the solution of this problem, try to do it by yourself. Okay, so the solution is like this. You will get the output like this. And how you get these outputs, I will explain step by step. As you can see, there are mainly three while loops. One if statement inside this while loop, another if statement inside the other while loop, and one break statement and a continue statement. So the three while loops are: the first one, the outer while loop, is starting from here to here. So the outer while loop starts from here to here. The next while loop is from here to here. And the inner while loop is from here to here. Okay. So the different variables used here are I is equal to 1, j is equal to 5, k is equal to 10 and n is equal to 20. Initially it will check the condition while n greater than 0. So initially n value is 20, and so it will come inside this while loop. This condition is true, so it will come inside this main while loop and check for the condition in the second while loop. So here k is also greater than 0 because k is equal to 10. So this condition is also satisfied and it will come inside this loop. Again, the next condition in the while loop is I less than j. I is initially 1 and j is initially 5. So 1 is less than 5. So this is also true. As this is true, it will check for the condition within this while loop. So first it checks if I equal to 3. So I is not equal to 3 now because I is equal to 1. So this break statement is not executed here. And it will come here and print I equal to, instead of percentage d, it will replace the value of I, that is 1. So the first thing is I equal to 1. In the first iteration, you will get I equal to 1. The I value is incremented here to a value equal to 2 and go back to this position. So now it checks for 2 less than 5. So 2 is less than 5. So it comes inside this loop and checks whether I is equal to 3. So now also I is not is equal to 3. So the break statement is not executed. It comes down here and prints the value of I. Now the value of I is equal to 2. So it will print I equal to 2. The value of I is again incremented to 3. Now it again checks 3 less than 5. Checks 3 less than 5. 3 is less than 5. So it comes inside and checks if 3 equal to 3. Because I value is now equal to 3. So at this moment, this condition is true. And the break statement inside this if is executed. The break statement actually exits from the currently executing while loop. So this is a while loop in which this break statement is executed. So it will come out of this loop. So on execution of this break statement, it will come out of this while loop to the next statement. So here the k value is decremented to 7. As we have written k is equal to k minus 3. K initial value is 10, so 10 minus 7, 10 minus 3 equal to 7 is the value of k now. So it is checking if k is equal to 4. So k is not equal to 4, so continue is not executed. Now it prints the value of k, that is k equal to 7. It prints k equal to 7, the current value of k. Then again go back to the while loop and again checks k greater than 0. Now also k is greater than 0 because k is equal to 7 now. So here also the condition is true and the condition is true and it will come inside this loop. So it is checking while I less than j. While I less than j means 3 less than j, that is true. Now also the condition is true because we exit from this loop using this break statement, and at that time the value of I was equal to 3. It is not incremented at that iteration. So 3 is less than j is checked, and this condition is true now, and it will check if 3 equal to 3. So the value of I is not altered in any of the other portions of the program. So I remains 3 itself. Okay. So whenever it enters this while loop again, it will check for whether 3 is equal to 3 and it will break from. This will break the operation and come out of this loop, this while loop, and execute the next statement. So again, k equal to k minus 3 is executed. That is, k will be now equal to 7 minus 3. 7 minus 3 means it is equal to 4. So on checking this condition, if k is equal to 4, this is actually satisfied. So when that is satisfied, it will continue the operation. So under this if, a continue statement is there. So this is executed. So continue statement means it will continue with the next iteration. So it will skip the statements written after this continue statement inside that loop and skip the iteration, and it will go back to checking the condition again. Okay, here also while k greater than 0 means while 4 greater than 0. That means it is true, it is again true, and it comes to this position while I less than j. That means 3 less than 5, that is again true. But when it comes here, I is equal to 3, that is if 3 is equal to 3 is true again, and it will break from that loop. So I value is not altered anywhere. So whenever it enters this while loop again, it will come out of that loop to here and decrements the value of k. So k is now decremented again by a value equal to 3. That means 4 minus 3 is done. 4 minus 3. So now the value of k is equal to 1. Now it is checking if k is equal to 4. So k is not equal to 4, so continue is not executed, and it will print the current value of k. So the current value of k is equal to 1. Right. So after printing this, it will go back to this while loop and checks whether 1 less than 1 greater than 0, because k value is 1. So 1 greater than 0 is also true, and it comes inside this while loop, and as I said, at this iteration also it will break from the current execution of that loop and decrements the value of k by 3. So 1 minus 3 is done. Now the k value is equal to minus 2. 1 minus 3, the k value is minus 2. So k is equal to 4, the condition is not satisfied, and it will not execute the continue statement, and it will print the value of k. Now the value of k is -2. So this value of k is less than 0 because the k value is now equal to -2. So this condition is not satisfied and it will come out of the loop. Okay, this condition is not satisfied, so it will come out of the loop to this position. Okay, now n minus equal to 5 is executed, that is n is equal to n minus 1. Initial value of n was 20, so 20 minus 5 is stored in n, that is the 15 value. 15 is stored in n and it will print the value of n. So the current value of n is 15. After this, it will go back to this main loop, outer loop, and checks n greater than 0. Now n is greater than 0 because 15 is greater than 0. This is true, so it will come inside and checks whether k greater than 0. The last stored value of k was -2, so this is not executed. As this while loop is not executed, the inner while loop or the if conditions, nothing will be executed. So these portions will not be executed anyhow. Okay, these portions are not executed from this moment because k is less than 0. So again, it will check alter the value of n by -5. So n is equal to n minus 5 means 15 minus 5. Now the value of n is equal to 10. So it will print the value of 10. N is equal to 10 now. So it will again come back here, come back to this position, and now 10 greater than 0 is checked. This is satisfied. As I said, as k is not greater than 0, this is not executed. Again, n value is decremented by 5 and the new value of k is n is 5 because 10 minus 5 value is equal to 5. And that 5 is printed, n is equal to 5. Okay, so it is again going here and checking that value, that is 5 is greater than 0. So 5 is greater than 0 and comes inside. This portion is not executed now, and n is equal to n minus 5 is again executed. So 5 minus 5 equal to 0 now. Okay, so that value of 0 is printed at the end, and it is again going back here and checking for the value condition n greater than 0. And now it is checking actually 0 greater than 0. So 0 is not greater than 0, so it actually exit out from the loop and the program ends here. So this is how we get this series of outputs for I, K and N. So you keep in mind the things that when the break statement is executed, it will come out of that particular loop in which it is executed. When a continue statement is executed, it will continue with the next iteration of that particular loop. It will continue with the next iteration of the particular loop. That means if continue is executed, everything written after that continue statements are skipped, and it will go back to checking the condition in the while loop, in the same while loop. Okay, So these two things are very important. Okay, so thank you.